Alcohol inks continue to be incredibly popular, so any new options for creating with them are always welcome in my world. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to combine alcohol inks, including Marabu's Rainbow, with Jacquard's Basic Dye to create colorful bursts and patterning. You can also combine Basic Dyes, which we have an introductory special at 25% off, with Claro Extender to create custom alcohol ink colors. I'm guessing you've seen products like Brusho, Ken Oliver Color Burst, and Cosmic Shimmer Pixie Powders and Shimmer Shakers that react with water. The process is to either apply them to a dry surface and add water, or sprinkle them on something that's already wet. Once the dye powder comes into contact with the liquid, bursts appear. It's a really fun technique and one that I've demoed several times and I enjoy using. Interestingly enough, you can create a very similar effect using Jacquard's Basic Dye, which are soluble in alcohol. And how amazing is that? Because now we have a powdered substance that we can combine with alcohol and blending solution and alcohol inks to create those really interesting bursts. Now, this fairly unremarkable green example here is just the basic dye in the color green that was sprinkled on. This is opaque white plastic, and I went ahead and added some alcohol to it. Now, I was under the impression that I might need to put blending solution or Claro Extender on here because they both contain resin like alcohol inks do, which is what helps adhere the stuff to the surface. But this was done with only alcohol. I just spritzed some on there. Now, it's reactive. You can come back and change it if you put something on it like alcohol ink or alcohol, but it stays put. So I thought that that was really interesting. I tested it on Yupo and it works the same way. The color stays put. So let me show you how this works. I'm gonna just bring in a piece, and I'm working with opaque white plastic. It's less expensive and I have found that it's a perfect substitute for Yupo. But if you're a Yupo fan, then by all means, go ahead and use Yupo. Now, like all dye powders, basic dye is sold by weight and not by volume. So even though this jar looks like it's mostly empty, however much is supposed to be in there, and I'm going to guess it's a quarter ounce, that's the amount of powder it takes to make that weight. I have taken hardly anything out of here. So I'm going to dip into the powder with a palette knife, and I'm just going to sprinkle this on. Now, that's more than I want in any one area. I try not to leave it clumped up because I find that the dye particles are not all going to disperse in the alcohol or the alcohol ink when I put it on there. So this is purple. Purple is made of red and green, and as you might expect, when I add alcohol to this, and my little green tape here denotes that this is alcohol, you can already see that there are specks of blue in here. Well, that makes perfect sense, because remember, a dye powder like this is meant to be mixed into something wet, and once all of those particles disperse in the liquid, then you would get an overall purple color. But for this, it's pretty awesome because you get these streaks of other color. You get these striations. And as I said, I could come back, once this is dry, I could come back and I could monkey with this again because it is still reactive. Now let me move that out of the way for 1 second and just mop up what's on here and bring this larger piece in. Now, what I thought was interesting, coming back to it being reactive, is that I can take alcohol in a bottle like this with the fine tip nozzle, and I can start bleeding it into the edges and creating all of those wispy edges, which we all like so much. Now, I didn't spend a lot of time messing with this, but you certainly can, and bigger piece of paper or opaque white plastic to work on, and obviously the bigger you get, the more room you have to work, and the more you can get that kind of wispy thing that goes on. Now, the one thing that's interesting, hear the difference? There is some dye powder left on here. Excuse me, some dye powder left on here. Not every particle is going to absorb the liquid and disperse its color at the same rate, and I probably had too much clumped in here. So what I have found is if I just take a clean piece of paper towel, I can come in and I can, you gotta wait till this is completely dry, but I can come in and I can brush off that excess, and there's still some here, but obviously I would brush all of that off. Now, if you look here, you can see a little bit of sparkly stuff, Rainbow, Marabu's Rainbow. All of the alcohol inks work, but I'm going to come back in a second and we'll talk about Rainbow. But before I do that, let's just bring in another piece of opaque white plastic. I'm going to use the same purple again because I have it open. And again, I'm just going to sprinkle a little color on there and just kind of move it around. And I want to show you that I can introduce a color of alcohol ink and get those really cool, similar results. So I'm going to Actually, let's come in this way. I'm going to put some alcohol down, and you can see the color starting to blend and disperse. And this is just a, this is one of Tim's alcohol inks. This is aqua. So I'm using a color that I know is going to work with purple. Alcohol inks tend to be pretty forgiving. They don't make mud easily. You have to really work at it. But I'm going to work with colors that are near one another on the color wheel to kind of avoid that. So I have my airbrush, and you can see that I can start pushing this color around like you would any other alcohol ink project that you were working on. Now, as this sits, and as the bigger particles of dye get enough of the alcohol and the alcohol ink in them, the color, as I said, will disperse kind of at different rates. So if I let this sit, you'll see that the striations and the streaks continue to appear. If I think I need a little bit more alcohol over here, it's easy enough to just come in and to start doing that. And as I said, when you have a little bit of those particles, you can kind of feel them. It's a little bit of crumblies. Once this is completely dry, clean paper towel, brush them off, and you'll be good to go. So here comes the sparkly stuff, Marabu's Rainbow. It adds that colorful, sparkly look when added to alcohol inks, and it does the same thing when you're working in this manner with the basic dyes. So for this one, I added whatever color dye this was and some alcohol and rainbow, and if I hold this up, you can see that the rainbow effect is in various places. I agitated this one a reasonable amount so it moved around. If you look at this sample, conversely, that's more of the greens, you can see when I hold this up to get the reflection, if there it is, you can see that the rainbow color is kind of relegated to just certain spots. I didn't move it around as much. I kind of just put the drops on there and let the whole thing dry. I wanted to see how much dispersion there would be, and honestly, there wasn't a ton of alcohol on here, so none of it moved very much, which is why I've got this really cool spotted effect. So let me show you how this works. So here's the rainbow. I'm going to give it a shake. I'm going to work with blue and green. Let's try a couple of different powders in the basic dye line. And you really don't need this much. I mean, you could share bottles with friends. You could each buy some and split them up, and you would have a lifetime practically worth of use, unless you're doing an awful lot of alcohol ink work with them. All right, so I'm just going to wipe that off. I'm going to bring in some alcohol, and how cool is that? It's just so interesting the way that this works. Now, rather than my air compressor, this is a pretty dirty coffee stirrer, but I'm going to kind of mess with it. I want you to see that you can do the same kinds of things. Well, that's cool. There's some red on there that's adding an interesting kind of line. But you can do the same kind of things here with these dyes. And in fact, Jacquard says that if you use these dyes and some bottles and Claro Extender, you can make custom colored alcohol inks. So you can, I mean, there's lots of different ways to work with these. You can continue to work with them and get the striations and the color markings from the dyes, or you can simply make your own custom colored alcohol inks. All right, so I'm going to bring in some of the rainbow now, and I'm going to just sprinkle it on there, and there is nothing not to love about this stuff. I'm going to try to hold this up so you can see it. You can just see it moving around there. Let me kind of move this around. But I still have some fairly definite color areas, even though I've moved this around. So you can kind of keep this in color family areas if you want. Come in with the air compressor and really blow it around. It's entirely up to you. So if I hold that up, yeah, see, it's all going to move. And unfortunately, I can't really show you the rainbow, but you'll have to trust me when I tell you that it is now dispersed across this entire piece of opaque white plastic. If I want to do the same thing, and let's clean this off. If I want to do the same thing, I'm going to use the same colors just because they're handy. And I want to add in some different color with an alcohol ink color, I can certainly do that too. Grab some of the blue. That's, I'm sure, more than enough. Oops. Come in with some alcohol. Now this time I thought it might be a little bit more blended because of the way that I kind of dragged the colors around with the palette knife, but that's pretty good. So again, same thing. Let's bring in some Cool Perry this time, just because I happen to have it here, which is kind of almost a bluey purple. I've got that really cool effect going on. Sometimes you don't have to maneuver this or move this around all that much to get really, really interesting results. Yeah, that rainbow is just amazing. Now, bear in mind that Marabu's metallic alcohol ink colors are the same thing. They are particles that settle into the bottle until you shake them and loosen that mixing bowl, but they tend to be a transparent liquid with particles floating in it like the rainbow. If you talk about the Pinata or the or Tim's alcohol ink, the metallics, then you're going to get, even though it's metallic, again, floating in a liquid, this has a tendency to be far more opaque. Let me see if I can get this mixed up a little bit so that you can see what this looks like. So while I can see the color of the underlying ink or basic dye underneath the rainbow, if I were to put this copper on, what I'm going to do is get an opaque dot of copper. Now, there's certainly applications for this, and there's plenty of ways to use it, but it's just the point being made that they're going to behave a little bit differently because you're going to get, because you're starting with a different thing. Rather than a transparent color like you're getting here or with rainbow, with the metallics, you're going to get that more opaque coverage. But I can slide this around and I can start maneuvering things. Sometimes I think I like working with a coffee stirrer best of all. And again, you can't really see it, but the color is still dispersed. Let's tip that up quickly. Yep, nah, it's not going to work. The color is still dispersing. I've still got striations and all kinds of cool things going on in here. I've got the rainbow effect, and I've got some metallic. So all the kind of wonderful sparkly things that I love are absolutely present in this messy little piece. So there you go. More options, yet more options to play with alcohol inks. I don't think I'll ever get tired of experimenting with them, and when you bring in the basics dyes like this, it just opens an entire world of possibilities.